out of bounds on the 3-yard line, and so they'll come back to the 35 and kick it off again with the wind at his back.
Those are those kind of little errors that you just can't afford to make against a team like Alabama. You want a penalty.
Alabama looking to retain its number one ranking, to win its 25th in a row, and to get Paul Bear Bryant that 300th win. Riggs kicking off again. This time the ball stays in the center of the field, and that's a good kick with the wind. Darrell White in the end zone says, "I'm not going to bring it out." So Alabama takes over. First and 10 at their own 20-yard line. The knee that he had operated on last year start the second quarter. Ogilvy 42, Jackson 33, Jones 24, the backfield. Bendros wide to the left. And that is Jackson, the fullback, who gets across the 25 to the 26-yard line. And that's the kind of game that the wishbone loves to stack up on first down. Dave Lyons made the stop, but not until nearly a 6-yard gain.
The first half, Kentucky did very well on first down. Alabama had one pass that went for 34 yards. Other than that, the biggest gain they made on first down was 4 yards.
Second down and a long four. Jacobs rides Jackson into the line again. It'll be third down and short. Jeff Dennis, Earl Wilson, Epley Brooks, Tim Gooch, and Dave Lyons, the defensive front line for Kentucky.
This is the first fake of the triple option. The quarterback, seeing the tackle come across the line of scrimmage, lets the fullback have the ball. Jackson was hit quickly by the linebacker Schroeder.
Jim Bob Harris, we understand, has a sprained ankle. It is not a knee. Third down. Ogilvy's got the first down across the 30-yard line. First and 10, Alabama. Well, that is good news, and we saw Ricky Tucker come out without apparently his shoulder bothering him, so Alabama's injury report looks good.
Second part, of the Alabama offense is just a straight-ahead driving play where you give the ball to the tailback who is being led by the other halfback and the fullback. It's not an option. It's just simply powered out.
Darrell White is in as a split end and is wide to the right. Number 30. Jacobs on first down is going to throw to Darrell White and underthrows him at the 39-yard line. Tom Petty filling in for Bemis Mukes, the left cornerback who was hurt, made the stop.
And Greg Long read the play very well. It was a reasonably good inside fake, but the two Kentucky defenders did not take the bait. They were out there on top of the play.
Second down. We gave you the defensive front for Kentucky. Smith and Schroeder, the linebackers. Petty and Motley, the cornerbacks. Long and Jacobs, the safeties. Time and the ball is handed off for about a yard gain to Billy Jackson, and that's his third carry on this drive. And it'll be third and 8. Scott Schroeder submarined him, the sophomore linebacker.
I thought he made a great run. You know, he always talk about somebody making a great run when it's for long, long yardage, but he was hit at the line of scrimmage. He's in perfect running position, has his weight perfectly on balance. He bounced off the first man, bounced again, made a little gain when he shouldn't have gotten anything.
14 yards per carry rushing. Imagine that. Crouch puts wide to the right. Bendros has come back in. He's to the left, and that's Jackson with the ball, and hanging on to him is that good tackle, Tim Gooch. Hey, he is a good one, bud.
The entire Kentucky defense has played well. Alabama made the 148-yard touchdown drive right before the half, but other than that, in spite of bad field position, the Kentucky defense has been able to stay in there with them.
Chris Jacobs goes deep. Number 19, Woody Humphrey, will kick the ball into the wind, and Alabama's been stymied after picking up one first down. 14 to nothing. We're in the third quarter. High snap. Humphreys gets the ball away, and the wind is going to hold it up a little bit, and Jacobs takes it without benefit of a fair catch, and down he goes at the 33-yard line. Brooks 45, Charlie Jackson 23, the running back. Randy Jenkins 12 is the quarterback. Oops, it lost the football. Belongs to Alabama, belongs to Warren Lyles, the middle linebacker. That is the fifth turnover. 3 interceptions and 2 lost fumbles for Kentucky.
And that's one that you should never fumble. It's just a straight handoff. If you're running the option plays, well, that's a sort of a high-risk thing. But here, Jenkins is simply turning and trying to hand the ball off. He got the ball all right from the center, just didn't get it back quite deep enough, and he and Jackson failed to connect.
I think Randy Jenkins will tell you, unless he turns around in a hurry, that he has not played well thus far this game. First down at the 31-yard line. Let's see if Alabama can make something happen here. That is Colleen, who has come in at quarterback, and he gets a good hit after picking up about 4 yards. Jacob's not in there, and Ken Coley. We've seen three quarterbacks today. We've not seen Walter Lewis, who played a great deal last week. We've not seen Alan Gray, but we've seen Jacobs and now Coley, and for one brief series, the freshman Paul Fields. I don't know how many times I've said today that Scott Schroeder made the tackle, but Scott Schroeder made the tackle on that last play of Coley. It is second down and 7 to go. The ball inside the 28 of Kentucky. And first down, Jacobs hanging on along with Chuck Smith. But inside the 20 goes Billy Jackson, and it's first and 10 from the 19.
Good read here on the triple option. Jacobs getting the ball, and you can see a beautiful block on Gooch. Just absolutely smothered him right under. He's double teamed, rolled, and two people on you. You maybe should always be blocked.
The Crimson Tide is rolling. I assume that's Jackson with no number on his back, because I think he just took it off him when they made the tackle. Coley pitches out and in the backfield, and there's a play by Greg Long, the good strong safety on Major, or rather Joe Jones. Jones has had one good run today, has been involved in two fumbles, and that time was hit behind the line of scrimmage by Greg Long. But he is a good one.
Kentucky playing totally for the run on the last play. Jacobs comes back in. Really, Bear has mixed it up so much, it's hard to anticipate what play they're going to call.
Second down and 11. 14 to nothing, Alabama. Jacobs back to throw. Flips it out here. To Jones, Jones. Near a first down at the 11-yard line. It'll be third down and 2 to go. Fran Kersey watches. Chuck Smith and Chuck Jones make the stop. And Alabama is rolling.
Little semi-screen. Most screen passes go all the way out to the sidelines. This was a short screen that dumped off almost like a safety valve, but the guard and tackle were out there blocking ahead of it to set it up.
Charlie Williams has come in at fullback, number 38. Jackson is up for the moment. They took too much time.
I think they did.
Third and 2.
He's been changing the play at the line of scrimmage. We can hear him quite often with our parabolic microphone picking it up. And that time it just took him a little bit too long to check the signal.
Big difference between third and 2 and third and 7.
It's the difference between winning and losing.
And when, especially when you're inside the 15-yard line, and they march it outside the 15-yard line to about the 16. And now Larry Brown comes in. Larry Brown can come in either as number 79, a right tackle, or number 83, a tight end. Larry Brown has got his 83 jersey on now, so he comes in as tight end. And here's Jacobs at the line of scrimmage. Third and about 8. Jacobs back to throw. Goes out here to Ogilvy. Long trips him up with a fine arm tackle. And it's fourth down and 5 to go. Greg Long, the junior out of Lexington, Kentucky, trips up Major Ogilvy after the little swing pass.
The same play that they hit a moment ago for the big gainer. Jacobs dropping back, looking, trying to look the defense off. Now he turns, sees Ogilvy, who was just curled out into the flat. The lineman weren't there that time to make the block. It was a reasonable gain, but not enough for the first down.
A 31-yard field goal attempt by Peter Kim. He's already hit on field goals of 28 and 38. One from in front, one from the left, and this is from the right, and there's another flag. As we told you, he's 2 for 2 today, 5 for 7 on the year field goals. Let's call this 35-yard kick, and let's call it good. It is 17 to nothing. Three times Alabama's been held to the field goal, but three times Peter Kim has come through with the field goal, and the Crimson Tide leads Kentucky 17 to nothing. Jim Clark will kick it off. 8:41 to go, third quarter. It is Charlie Jackson and Henry Parks who are deep, and it is Henry Parks at the 7. To the 10, Parks busts through a good tackle as he crosses the 15-yard line and the 20-yard line by Ricky Tucker. and Robbie Jones.
Robbie Jones made the tackle.
Number 97. Well, now let us see if Randy Jenkins can get something going. He has fumbled, and the only time they've had the ball this half, and that gave Alabama a chance for three. They have thrown three interceptions, and the two fumbles have both been Randy Jenkins. There goes Randy Brooks, the fullback, and Randy Brooks gets some decent yardage out near the 30-yard line. But it'll be second down and about six to go. Jackie Klein, number 98, and Randy Scott, number 50, made the tackle.
And a new offensive set that time by Kentucky. Two tight ends and a wing back, which gives you eight men along the line of scrimmage ready to block immediately.
And Kentucky is averaging about 355 yards total per game. Well, I tell you, Alabama is averaging 457 per game. Hey, good hole for Brooks, and he took advantage of it and has a first down across the 35-yard line. Thomas Boyd made the stop, but Brooks, as he got to the line of scrimmage on the left side, found an opening to his left and took advantage of it.
When you put the wing back out, as Kentucky has, you expect the defense to move that way. Boyd, the linebacker, read this one. It was a handoff back to the short side. The right side of the Alabama line closed down too rapidly, but Boyd recovered to make the tackle.
7:40 to go. The wind is at the back of Randy Jenkins. You wonder when he's going to put it up. It'll be more difficult in the fourth quarter, and they're down by 17 points. Now he's going to put it up now if he can. And here's Randy Brooks, and Randy Brooks stepped out of bounds. Gained about a half a yard on the play. That is all. He took the ball and looked up, and here came Mr. Thomas Boyd. And so Brooks figured it's just as good to go sideways a half a step as being knocked back about five.
It gives you confidence a little bit to complete any kind of a pass. There was not much gain on that play, but he had to react quickly to get rid of the ball and got it on target.
No less a quarterback than John Brody of Stanford in San Francisco said, if I completed a two-inch pass on my first one, that gave me confidence. Just get one in the hands of a receiver. Here's Brooks trying to get wide. That's blocking out there across the 40. And out to the 43-yard line. And it'll be third down and short yardage to go. Ricky Tucker is in there and playing, and he and De Niro, numbers 18 and 51, made the tackle. Third and about a yard and a half to go. And in with the play comes number 91, Tom Shadowin. Shadowin has told Jenkins. Jenkins will tell the huddle, and let's see if Kentucky can get this drive going.
Brooks has got some speed and also some niftiness. Good run that last time.
He's only 5'8 and a half as a fullback, weighs 185. They're going to throw on third and short. Loops it out here, and nobody is near it. I guess the nearest man to it was Rod Francis, who just came into the ballgame, number 32.
He was trying to run a bootleg and then throw a screen back against the grain. Alabama didn't take the bait for the bootleg. He was turned in, and they had people out covering the screen pass.
Major Ogilvie's got to look into the sun, and Randy Jenkins has a chance to kick with the wind. Ogilvie moving over because they've moved the ball to the hash mark on the far side. Rushes on, gets it away. Beautiful kick. Ogilvie watches it soar over his head, and they may be able to down it inside the five. If they hurry, they don't. The ball goes into the end zone. We'll come out to the 20. Ball just seemed to run away from Kentucky. They're trying to say they touched it, but I think it got a grab possession of it inside the five.
It did never have possession of the ball. They were almost in position to do so, but the ball took a very hard, very fast bounce, as it usually does on AstroTurf, particularly with the wind.
We have a fourth quarterback in for Alabama this afternoon. Allen Gray has come in, number 14 out of Tampa. How many national championship teams do you see with using four or five quarterbacks per game?
How many teams do you see that have four or five?
That's better. Mitch Ferguson is in at fullback, but that's Allen Gray carrying the football. And Gray gets across the 25 out to the 27, where Chuck Smith makes the stop. Alabama clearly in control of this football game. The first half, the Kentucky defense hung in there, still hanging in there, but Alabama's got the ball too often or too much of the time.
When we first saw Gray against Georgia Tech, I thought he ran better than the other Alabama quarterbacks, and here it appears that that view we had is correct. He's got speed and acceleration as well as a good peripheral vision.
James Mallard wide to the left. yet. Mitch Ferguson, the fullback. Whoops. Does not have the ball. That's Lenny Patrick that does have the ball. And number 87, Jeff Dennis, has him.
Kentucky defense hits. Truly do.
Well, that's what Barry, we said it before. Barry Switzer of Oklahoma said after playing, he said that Kentucky defensive line can really come after you. And they've been coming after Alabama time and time again, but their offense keeps giving them the football and an excellent field position. 17-0 Alabama. How much in the third quarter? 5:20. Ambrose wide left. Patrick and Nix and Ferguson are the backs. And there's a pitch back. Patrick steps out of bounds, they say, at the 31-yard line. And if that's so, that's a first down, Alabama. Smith and Schreiber, the linebackers, ran him out. But it's a first down, Alabama, at the 31-yard line.
And a very nifty execution of the play by Gray.
Next week, Bud and I and ESPN, among other games, will be down in Tallahassee, Florida. Remember, one national news service picked Pittsburgh to be number one in the nation. Well, we've got Pittsburgh against Florida State next weekend. Allen Gray with the football. Jumps over one tackler and gets across the 35. Where Chuck Smith finally puts him down.
Almost popped this one. Kentucky going for anyone who might have the ball on the triple option. All you have to do is miss one tackle and somebody's got some running room. We see Gray start down the line. Fake to the fullback. Lead blocked by Jones, and he sees the daylight following that halfback's block and almost popped it.
Mark Crowder's come back in. Nix comes wide to the right as they go out of the I formation. Pitch back to the tailback, Lenny Patrick. He's got a lot of speed. Look out, I'll see you later. Lenny Patrick down to the 10-yard line, inside the 10, down to the 4. First and goal to go, Alabama. Caught by Motley, who had the angle, but Patrick had great speed.
I formation. I think they caught Kentucky a little bit by surprise with the I formation. Patrick sees the daylight as you can from the I, turns it upfield, breaks away from the linebacker, then turns on the speed. It appeared that he might be able to take it all the way. He's really legging it, but he doesn't quite have it as the defensive halfback Motley comes across and knocks him out of bounds.
First and goal to go. Jones has come in. Patrick is out. That left halfback. Mitch Ferguson with the football near the goal line. They'll mark it at the 1. It is second down. Alabama leading 17-0. Looking for their 25th in a row. And I have to say right now, looks very good for Paul Bear Bryant to win his 300th game of his highly successful, and that's an understatement, coaching career. Lenny Patrick comes back in. They like to let the people here at Alabama that set up the touchdown score them. Now let us see if that is true by giving the ball to Patrick. They've done it with Ogilvie earlier in the game. And they do it with Patrick this time. Touchdown.
The straight ahead power drive play. Gray just simply turns, hands the ball to Patrick, who follows the other two backs, goes up into the air, into the end zone for the touchdown. Let's take a look at it again from ground level, and you can see the two lead blocks by the fullback and halfback, and then the takeoff into the air by Patrick for the score.
All right, it is Peter Kim with Woody Humphrey to hold for his first after attempt. The last time they went for 2 points on the conversion. And that is good, and it is 24-0 Alabama. You know, Paul Bear Bryant made a great deal of comprehensive sports news program on television, exclusively on ESPN. Tim Clark to kick it off to Parks or Jackson. Jackson waiting just a step in the end zone, brings it out, coming for the sidelines, and rides as far as about the 13.5-yard line, where he is ridden down there by Alabama's Jeff Fagan, a running back, number 35, a sophomore out of Hollywood, Florida. And now the finger points right back at Randy Jenkins, listed as a freshman. He won the game last year, one game, broke his hand in the second, and he's the man that Fran Kersey came to Bud Wilkins and said, I want you to meet this young man because he can throw the football. Well, he has not shown too much today. He has been harassed. Francis is in the game along with Brooks, number 32. That is Brooks carrying the football. That gets across the 15-yard line and out to about the 17. Call it second and seven. Warren Lyles made the stop along with Scott Holman, number 93.
I think Jenkins is going to be a great football player. He is a good football player. He hasn't had experience, obviously, but he's got the size. He's got the quick arm. He's got the good vision. And he's not going to look at many defenses as good as the defense he's looking at today.
Well, I tell you what, when you play against Oklahoma, play against Alabama, you are getting quite an indoctrination as a freshman quarterback. Jenkins to throw, downfield, and the ball is almost intercepted by Wilcox, intended for Kerry Bear. That would have been a fourth interception, but a diving interception for Wilcox, who always had already has one of the three.
Jenkins really has been pressured all of the time. He just did not have a good shot to deliver the ball the way he wanted to. He did get rid of it, almost had it on target. Alabama has truly been putting the pressure on him.
Third down, about six to go. Baird goes to the right. 3 minutes, 3 seconds to go. Third quarter, 24 to nothing. Tide of Alabama. And there's Brooks. Showing that speed, but he's got to get outside and won't do it, and that's Ricky Tucker. You don't see him in your picture, but he's up the field to your right, and he's the man that tripped him up. A lot of other people put him, but Ricky Tucker, there he is, just walking out to the left there. He's the man that made the play, and this is as close as we've come to a measurement all day long.
Well, Brooks made a great effort. He ran that one like he...
A first down, Kentucky. Back early second quarter. Had a couple of fumbles, stepped that up. They had a chance to go for a score, fumbled the ball, had to settle for a field goal, and fumbled the ball again on the snap. Here's Brooks again coming this way. Well, I guess it's Randy Brooks right, Randy Brooks left. It used to be, you know.
O.J. right and O.J.
right. Eddie Lowe makes the stop, and there's another name that's well-known to Alabama fans. His brother Woody Lowe was an All-American here out of Phoenix City, Alabama. Eddie's number is 57. Gain of two on the play, second down and eight. Baird goes to the right. And Alan Watson has only been thrown to twice today, caught none to the left. Jenkins back to throw. Jenkins has some time. Batted down by big number 99. And that is Richard Shaw, a junior out of Columbiana, Alabama.
First time.
And he is a walk-on, by the way. How many times do they walk on at Alabama?
Well, I don't know. I'd like to play at Alabama, so that's the first time really that Jenkins has had a reasonable amount of time to get set and deliver the ball. The lane he was trying to throw in was blocked.
Richard Shin, I think I said Shaw. Richard Shin is gone and made that outstanding play. It's third and long for Jenkins. Dumps the ball out. Look out. That's the second time that Campbell has caught the ball, and Benny Perrin rides him down. Campbell is their number one receiver, the second time he's caught the ball today.
It's a very quick toss to Campbell. Jenkins back. He's looking at Campbell all of the way. He gets the ball to him, but Alabama moved right with his eyes, and the tackle is made very, very quickly by Perry.
10 minutes on the line of scrimmage. Do not rush as Jenkins kicks the ball away to Coley, and Coley is down immediately inside the 35-yard line, where it is first down and 10. And a fine play there made by Kentucky's David Buzz Mears of Kentucky. Well, they get a week off. I'm sure they're happy of that before they come back against LSU in a home game at Lexington.
That week off will help their injuries considerably.
First down, 10, high formation. They've shown it a few times today, even though they're known as a wishbone. Tailback, and that is Patrick picking up a couple of yards. Well, in talking to Alabama before this game, they said, Ben Orcutt, who scored last week against Vanderbilt, is out injured, so we may put in Paul Carruth, number 16. They have shown us thus far running backs Ogilvy, Nix, Fagan, Ferguson, Williams, Jackson, Jones, Patrick, and Fagan. Again, but no Carruth. Plus four quarterbacks we've seen today.
No one's tired.
Second down, Alan Gray is a quarterback here. That is Ferguson, first down across the 45-yard line. A senior from Augusta, Georgia.
Ferguson does a very good job of reading here. It's the first of the triple option. He picks up the ball. Watch him fake to the inside and then break it back to the outside, reading his blocks. Nice game.
Alabama's defense, Well, they've done it again thus far. They are shutting out Kentucky as they have 15 times in their 28-game history. And there's Lenny Patrick, and he almost squirted loose. Loose enough to get 7 or 8 yards before the free safety Chris Jacobs made the stop. Here's an Alabama team that was embarrassed. Well, they won the ball game 59-35, but they didn't like the idea of giving up 35 points to Mississippi. Vanderbilt never scratched last week. And right now we've entered the third quarter, so they've gone 7 quarters in the last 2 games without giving up a single point. That's the kind of defense that Paul Bear Bryant likes. Capacity crowd, Legion Field, Birmingham, Alabama. The quest for number 300. The quest for a third national championship in a row. Down and, oh, I would say 7 or 8 yards, and I would assume they would take the yard. Otherwise, it'd be third and about a half a yard to go. They walk it off. Boy Smith tells us that they were in motion. So now we can begin the fourth quarter. Second down and 8 to go from the 30, make that the 47-yard line of Alabama. A Crimson Tide sending way wide Jeff Fagan to the right. Mallard to the left. And Lenny Patrick, the fresh football. Oh, is he quick? Is he quick? Still on his feet, dragged down inside the 15. You know, in the old days, they used to say only a sophomore. Now they say, gee, he's just a freshman.
When you give them the eye formation as a balance against the wishbone, it takes away the normal keys that you've been practicing all week. Watch Patrick here as he reads the defense and gets some marvelous blocking downfield. He just has got more speed than he realized, and he changed hands with the football. Last man slows him up, but he breaks that tackle, and his rhythm broken. He is caught from behind.
Look who made the tackle. Bemis Mukes, number 2, who is back in the ballgame. Now Paul Carruth is in, number 16, a freshman for the first time this year. And Mitch Ferguson takes, whoops, that's a fake by Gray inside the 5-yard line. Rode the fullback into the line, the fake pitch back, and then Gray carries the ball down, and I believe it's first down and goal to go.
Gray is exceptional with the running attack from the wishbone. He does a great job of reading here, and he also gets a great fake from the fullback. It appears as though he has given the fullback the ball. And it appears the fullback has it. However, Gray pulls it back out, turns upfield, and the great, great fake set the play up.
And now Ferguson has the football, and everybody's looking at Gray, and Ferguson's got the touchdown. As Alabama just about tells everybody here in Legion Field, and those of you watching, that Paul Bear Bryant joins Pop Warner and Amos Alonzo Stagg with 300 or more victories.
Great blocking by the offensive line. The problem of how do you defend all three options? You start trying to defend any one of them, and they burn you with the others.
It is 30 to nothing with Peter Kim in. Jones and Eddie Lowe are the linebackers. Heron and Gay and Sprinkle are all in there, and Coley is a defensive back spot. You've seen him play as a quarterback, and now he's playing defensive back on the right corner.
Getting ready for one platoon football.
Second down, about seven. Here comes Brooks again. Linebacker shot, did not get him. Robbie Jones shot, and Stan Gay made the tackle, along with number 96, Randy Edwards, who's the new middle guard.
The linebackers read the blocks, and if the block is down in front of him, you go ahead and shoot the gap, as we can see him doing here. Brooks read that very well, stopped short. The linebacker overran it slightly, but the rest of the pursuit after Jones missed.
And it belongs to Alabama.
Amazing.
That's incredible. This is the fourth game, and already Alabama's gained nearly 1,500 yards.
They just keep coming at you. Keep coming at you. Keep coming at you. Wear you down.
Earl Collins wide to the right. James Fowler, the speedster, wide to the left. The pitch out by Jeff Fagan.
And that was beautiful execution by Gray. Normally, quarterbacks, if they don't get to keep the regular rhythm of throwing the ball along as they move along parallel to the line of scrimmage, they forget that the lateral can open up downfield. Here's Gray reading. He turns upfield as though he's going to run with the football. And while he's moving upfield, they close in on him, and he executes the option on the defensive safety man. Fagan does a great job here. This is determined ball carrying.
41 yards later, he goes into the end zone as Peter Kim has just added the extra point. And the score is Alabama 38 and Kentucky nothing as the tide is rolling.
You stay in there.
Alabama very rarely strays far from home. They're going to be up in the New York City area next week. ESPN will be there. And they're over in Giant Stadium in East Rutherford to play Rutgers. And look out, Rutgers. I tell you, this is a good-looking Alabama team. Whoops, Jackson fumbled. That's the third time on a kickoff that a Kentucky man has fumbled the football. Once at the four, once in the end zone, and now at about the eight or nine.
And they continue to have miserable field position. The best field position they've ever had the ball is on their own 36 after a fumble. They've only had it outside the 20 one other time, and that was at the start of the second half.
You say 7 seconds is a long time to run 41 yards. Tried with people hanging all over you and breaking tackles. That's remarkable for Jeff Fagan.
And wearing all of your football equipment, too.
First down from the 9-yard line for Kentucky. Kentucky this year has not been shut out, but if they are shut out by Alabama, it'll be the 16th time that Alabama has shut out Kentucky.
Very odd-looking pair of hip pads.
Oh, they call the football again! Touchdown, Alabama! Mike Pitts and Randy Edwards. I think they're going to say that Mike Pitts may have the ball, but we'll see if we can see it. One of the two.
Supposed to be a very safe play. You just hand the ball off to the tailback. However, he's hit so quickly that he has no chance to really get the ball put away. Ball bounces into the end zone, recovered. Alabama touchdown, and I believe it was Pitts who came up with the ball.
11-14. That means that in just 20 seconds, they have scored again. And now Peter Kim comes on, and the scoreboard lights up to 45-0. Randy Edwards was on him, meaning that Jackson fumbled the ball at the 9, and on the next play, Kentucky fumbled the ball, and they recovered it in the end zone. That's the kind of day Kentucky's been having. Parks will try not to fumble the ball, and now that he's got it, he's not going to bring it out. They'll take it over first and 10 at the 20-yard line. 11:14 to go in the game. Now, there's some of the first-string men. Warren Lyles is number 91. Byron Braggs, number 47. Gary DeNiro, number 51. Jackie Klein, 98. Those are the fellows who are the first-string defensive line, along with E.J. Jr., and they're just taking it easy now.
And you can see that Alabama is leading in scoring offense in the Southeastern Conference, and they're going to be very close to leading scoring offense in the NCAA.
Bear to the right, Watson to the left. And Jenkins to throw it, and he threw it awfully quick. Baird hardly had the time to make his turn. Well, you know that Alabama is third in the nation in scoring with 42 points per ball game before this game, and that average will go up at least a little bit as they already have 45.
And it's going to be very difficult for Kentucky to keep them from scoring some more, and it's not that Bear wants to roll it up, it's just that he's playing his second and third string people who are excellent athletes.
Now Brooks at the line of scrimmage, breaks away, and he is dragged down. Gay and Edwards made the stop. Randy Edwards around the ankles, the freshman middle linebacker of Marietta, Georgia, number 96. A gain of 8-7 on the play, put the ball at the 27 of Kentucky. That is second down and 3.
And the draw play worked. If you're getting a very heavy rush, as Kentucky has been getting all day from Alabama, the draw play does tend to slow down the rush because rushing linemen will run past the ball carrier, and that sets up the play.
Brooks, the outstanding ball carrier, and has the ball again, and can turn the corner this time. Gee, what a nice play by Kevin Coley on the far side. What a nice play by Coley. He simply played off the blocker and forced Brooks wider and wider and wider until he finally went out of bounds.
Brooks is a fine ball carrier, and this time we get a clean handoff by Kentucky in the backfield. Brooks is looking for daylight to cut inside. He makes a little inside fake, sets up the blockers a little bit, then breaks it to the outside. Coley does come across after being partially blocked to make the tackle, but it's first down Kentucky.
Ball at the 36-yard line, and this time it is Rod Francis. Out of Louisville, a sophomore, has been troubled with fumbleitis, and you can see that today the entire Kentucky team has been troubled with fumbleitis. And Danny Castile, number 92, and Eddie Lowe made the tackle.
When you get hit as solidly as you do by Alabama, ball carriers have got to be particularly careful with the ball. They put it away. They can't be carrying it loosely and expect not have it knocked out.
Second and 7, Kentucky trying to get something going. Still double team.